Bye-bye. Yeah, wow. That was pretty bad. It isn't the first time this idea has been done, where the mythical and most powerful god of some place has turned into an absolute dickhead where he's all above it all and sick with humanity below him. Hell, Greek mythology is full of stories about the gods pulling absolute dick moves on people who only slightly wronged them all because they thought they were above everything. Well, because they were, but that's not the point. The point is that Zeekeeper is a total douche in Dream Team after spending all this time assembling and setting the ultimate to find him. It's not even played for laughs, this is straight up assholery. The basic gist is that the Zeekeeper wants Mario to drain the Mushroom Kingdom's treasury in order to pay him for his help. This happens after the boss fight where Zeekeeper learns enough respect for the Mario Brothers to be gracious enough to allow them to spend 80 trillion coins on his superpowers to save the island. If Mario could talk in this game, I would suggest to tell Zeekeeper that if he doesn't help, his island is screwed, and without any worshippers, his existence is essentially worthless, so fuck your price tag. Chop chop. Zeekeeper is a terrible character with no comedic redemption, but his boss fight is what puts salt on the wound. This is the end game, so things start going from challenging to bullshit now. The problem is that what Alpha Dream thought would increase the challenge would be to break the whole turn-based concept of this RPG in the favor of the enemy in every case. Zeekeeper isn't the worst case of this happening, but it's still not fun when Zeekeeper is able to combo four of his attacks together to hit for big accumulated damage before Luigi even gets one turn to spin the tables in his favor for the short time that he gets to. Most of your damage in this fight is going to be likewise dealt with counterattacks rather than giving the player any agency to deal their own damage, and what all of this means is that in order to get a chance at living through all the bullshit, the player will need to start perfecting their dodges instead of just being good at them. A normal amount of QTE screw-ups for a blind playthrough will set the player back 1/3 to 1/2 of their health bar, and again, this battle is bullshit for doing so. To give this boss fight some credit, the QTEs aren't especially hard to deal with. You can learn them and they give you good windows to figure them out. The other issue with this is that since the boss gets to attack so much and only have those attacks dish out retaliatory damage, the Zeekeeper fight gets to be one that drags and drags. It gets worse when you remember how repetitive this fight is. Zeekeeper's attacks follow a more strict pattern than others, so you learn what's coming up fast in the fight and just have to wait until the game gives you the next turn and then start the whole rigmarole again. Putting big boring sections where all you're doing is dodging attacks is not what makes a good boss fight about. A part of it is to be challenging and allowing the player to use the mechanics given to them in order to find strategies to hurt the boss best. So when the game just gives you the strategy gift wrapped and says try your best, it's just a bore fest. Do the QTEs, do the occasional jump attack, repeat for 10 minutes, and then continue down the road to the game's disappointing conclusion. This battle happens within 80% of the game being over. What else could you expect from it at this point?